Today we are going to get some warm color tones from this image using the free Snapseed app. This is a RAW DNG file. So we have dedicated develop menu where we will try to get as much info from the image for a good starting point for editing. Here are the sliders. I'm gonna first decrease the highlights to get details, especially from the sky. Increasing the shadows for details in the darker areas. Bit of contrast and structure. This may sound odd, but I'm gonna add a lot of saturation mainly to get colors from the DNG file. Later, I'll tone down these colors. Applying it. I'm gonna be doing different edits for the foreground and the background. So we'll create a separate mask for the foreground. This will be a one-time process. So we'll create a dummy curves edit specially to create a selection mask. I'll just darken the image, which will help to get the mask more easily. Now going to the masking screen, we'll brush on the foreground to get the mask. We'll be careful, especially on the edges between the foreground and the background. Zooming in and brushing precisely. This will take a bit of time, but it is a one-time work. We'll fast forward this. I'll remove the dark effect of getting the mask done. If you overdo it, just need to bring down the brush value to zero and brush out the mask. So here is the completed selection. We'll reset the values of the curves. And copy the effect, which basically copies the curves edit with the selection mask. Now I'll apply a couple of selective filters. One on the skin, where I will reduce the saturation. We'll reduce the intensity of the blues in the foreground by decreasing the saturation. Next, tune image to reduce the overall saturation a bit. Couple more selective filters. One on the reds to get more pop out of them by increasing the contrast. And couple in the sky, where I'm gonna reduce the blues and darken top part of the sky. Now I'll go to View Edits and tap Insert in the 3-dot menu, which adds the earlier copied curves effect with the mask included. I'm gonna add overall brightness. When I apply, you can see it is affecting only the foreground as the mask is applied only on that part. Again, inserting the copy of the curves, this time applying contrast on the same parts, that is the foreground. Again, inserting the same, this time to darken the background. So going to the masking screen and inverting the mask. Now reducing the brightness. Little masking work to get some brightness back on the horizon. Now a different edit with curves, darkening the overall image. With masking, applying it on the top and bottom parts of the image. Now inserting the original curves effect again. Here I will be trying to get a bright rim effect on the edges of the foreground. So moving the top point of the curves towards left to overexpose the highlights. Also adding a bit of orangish tones by dragging the red and green curves towards left. Going to the masking screen, we'll carefully brush out the mask everywhere except on the edges of the foreground. More precise work needed here. This effect gives a bright light around the edges of the foreground. Next, we'll do some dodging with the brush tool. Brushing on these minute details to get that subtle improvement to the overall image. Inserting again, darkening the background a bit more. Also the foreground a bit. Now to get the warm color tones, you could increase the temperature in white balance. But I'm gonna go with a different route. This way you can get a couple of different looks if you need. First I'm gonna turn the image to white by dragging the bottom point of the curves to the top. Again with curves, now we'll drag the top point of the blue curve a bit down to turn this to yellow. And also pulling the green curve down, which adds magenta, in turn combining the yellows adds orangish tones. We'll save this as a separate copy. Now we'll delete both the last curve's edits going to the double exposure, adding the saved orange image, and trying different blending modes. Selecting overlay here. We'll reduce the intensity by decreasing the opacity to around 25% to get that warm tones overall. You also could try different modes to get different looks. The final look here. Hope you found some useful tips in the video. Thank you all for watching.